Hi and welcome to our Stimpod Quick Start Guide for EMG. This video will demonstrate how to set up NNT monitoring on a patient using electromyography with the Stimpod. You are welcome to follow along using our printed Stimpod Quick Start Guide for EMG. Setup requirements. You will require the following. Your Stimpod NMS450X stimulator. An NMT monitoring cable EMG. An EMG electrode. Start off by checking that the batteries have been correctly inserted and switch on the Stimpod. An insert cable screen prompt will appear. The Stimpod is now ready to have an NMT monitoring cable connected. Connect the NMT monitoring cable EMG to the Stimpod. An open circuit detected screen prompt will appear. The Stimpod is now ready to have the monitoring cable connected to the EMG electrode. Properly clean the patient's skin area before attaching the EMG electrode. Securely attach the EMG electrode to the patient's arm by placing the most distal electrode above the muscle insertion point of the abductor pollicis, over the bone or joint. Place the EMG electrode over the muscle belly of the abductor pollicis. Now, place the stimulation electrodes on the most superficial aspect of the ulnar nerve, with a cathode, or negative black electrode, located 1 cm proximal to the wrist crease on the radial side of flexor carpi ulnaris. Note that the ambidextrous design of the electrode allows for setup on either the left or the right arm. Now connect the EMG cable to the electrode. Once connected, the LED color will change from red to blue, and the EMG indicator will appear on the Stimpod. The Stimpod is now ready to proceed with NMT monitoring. Secure the cable to the patient's arm in the most convenient location, preferably on the outside of the patient's forearm. You can now proceed with NMT monitoring by choosing either of the following stimulation options. Option A. Auto mode. Use the mode button to change the stimulation mode to auto mode. Press the Enter key to initiate the supramaximal current. It is very important to make sure that your patient is anesthetized at this point, but not relaxed yet. The Stimpod will now confirm your electrode placement and determine the optimal current for your setup. At the end of the sequence, the current will be set at the determined supramaximal current. Full case monitoring has now been initiated, and the Stimpod will continuously and autonomously monitor your patient's depth of block, guiding your patient through to a safe extubation. Option B, manual stimulation. Use the mode button to select the TOF mode. Manually adjust the current using the adjustment wheel, and press Enter to confirm your choice. Press the play button to initiate a single TOF sequence. Press and hold the play button for 2 seconds to initiate a repeat TOF stimulation. Thank you for watching our quick start guide for EMG. For further details on our products or NMT monitoring, please visit our website at www.zavin.com.